Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So in today's video, we're going to talk about the newly released Blackmagic Camera App update, the update 1.4. And this is just a new update available just now from Blackmagic if you are using your iPhone as a camera. Or also, a side note to that is that the Blackmagic Camera App is coming for Android later this year. It was announced at NAB like a month or so ago. And so if you're an Android user, look forward to getting a great camera app on your Android phone. So let's just jump right into this video here. First off, the update will give you some new stuff. It's going to support Blackmagic Cloud organizations, making it easier if you are a big organization to organize all of the footage going to the cloud. So for me, that's not so useful, but for some people, it might be very useful. We also have support for enabling frame guide, safe areas, and other options over the HDMI cable, which is super cool. So now you can, if you are using a HDMI monitor to monitor your shots, you can actually do the overlays like you were able to do on the pocket camera or the cinema camera. All of those, you can do that now on the HDMI. Control what you want to, or what kind of feed you want to send to the HDMI monitor, which is kind of cool. Then there are support for new frame guides overlays, which I think is kind of cool. Also, now when you are recording, you can swipe right to save screen brightness when recording, so it's going to dim the screen. However, that is only going to work if you are recording. So I can just show you how that works. So I'm just going to hit record, swipe right, and now you can see it's going to dim down the screen. I hardly can see anything. We also have the ability to customize grid overlays opacity, which simply just means if you are using the rule of thirds, you can just very easily make that more transparent, so it's not going to be as visible on your screen. Kind of a neat feature as well. Then there is a couple of audio fixes and bug fixes, which is kind of cool. But I am going to keep the most cool thing, I think, for the last, and that is the support for off-speed video clips. And what that is, I'll just jump into the app. So I'll just click here, and I have now 24 frames a second. And if I want to, you know, shoot something in slow motion, I can hit this OS icon right here. And here I can control the amount of frames. So I'm just going to put this at 48 frames a second, and I can hit record. And now I am going to record this clip at 48 frames a second, just going to stop it. Now when I play this back, it's going to shoot, or it's going to play back at 48 frames a second, which I think is kind of cool. That's going to be way easier shooting something in slow motion and then exporting it from the app and just directly into DaVinci Resolve. So you don't have to go in and do this speed ramping or slowing down the footage inside of DaVinci Resolve. So now you can do that in camera, which I think is kind of cool. Okay, anyway, I've been rambling long enough about this new update for the Blackmagic Pocket Camera App 1.4. So if you are a user of the app, go download it and get some new features. I think it's kind of cool. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.